and welcome. My name is Jocelyn, and today we are doing my second ever Empties video, and I think this one's even bigger than the last one I did. I remembered and reminded myself to keep and hold on to all of my empty products so that I could share them with you, and so that's what we're doing today. I decided that it was time to make this video because my little bucket is overfilling with stuff. So as you can see, this is kind of where I throw all of my products that I use up. You can see on top, there's a lot of skincare, hair care, all kinds of stuff. So I do have some makeup in here also. So I'm just gonna share all of this with you today. I think I'm gonna try and organize this a little bit to make showing and sharing it with you a little bit easier. So let's go ahead and do that first. So let's go ahead and start with makeup. Now, some of these things, if you have been keeping up with my Project Pan, is gonna be a little bit of duplicates, but for anybody new who doesn't enjoy Project Pans maybe, or just hasn't seen my channel at all, you won't have heard me talk about these products. And I did finish them up, so I'm going to include them in this video. The first product that I finished up is this foundation by Clinique. This is the Clinique Even Better Foundation. I have this one in the shade Alabaster. It's like the lightest shade they carry. It's my dead of winter shade, basically. This foundation was pretty good. It's not the best for people with oily skin. I have oily skin, but it worked pretty good for just a very natural finish. But Clinique's not cruelty-free, so I will not be repurchasing this. Next, I finished up two concealers. These were also in my project pan. These are, of course, the Tarte Shape Tape concealers. I have one in the shade Fair Beige and one in the shade Light. I do like these. I do find, however, that they're very drying under the eyes. For some reason, the rest of my face is very oily, but under my eyes gets very dry for whatever reason, so I do have to be kind of careful. I don't know that I would necessarily repurchase these. I feel like I have found concealers that work a little bit better for me. These are very full coverage though. I do also like these for spot treating around the face because I do get oily everywhere else, and these can be helpful this way, but I finished these two up. I did finish up a couple of primers. These are both deluxe size samples. The first is in Benefits Professional. This is okay. And then the other one is the Pores No Mores by Dr. Brandt. Again, this is okay. These are very similar primers for me, but they're also both from non-cruelty-free brands, so I will not be repurchasing these. Again, something else from my Project Pan. Promise, there are other products in this empties video, but it is a Bare Minerals Mineral Veil Primer. This is another deluxe size sample, and I actually really like this mineral veil. It works pretty well on my skin. It's one of the very first mineral veils or mineral setting powders that I've ever tried, and I like it. It works pretty well. I would consider repurchasing this. Recently, I also used up the Urban Decay Eyeshadow Primer Potion in the original version. I like this a lot. I don't totally love the paddle on this. I don't know. It's hard for me to get the product fully out, it feels like, but I do like this primer. I would consider repurchasing it. I did recently buy the Catrice primer because it's drugstore, it's much less expensive, and it's cruelty-free to try out, because this can get very expensive, and if I can find an alternative that works just as well for much cheaper, mine as well. My last two makeup products, the first is the Stila Waterproof Liquid Eyeliner, just in the shade Intense Black. I really like this eyeliner. I use it for lining the rest of my eye. I don't really like it so much for flicking out a wing. I don't quite get the sharpness that I get with the Kat Von D liquid liner. That is just like a holy grail for me for creating that sharp wing. I have not found really anything else that comes quite as close and is as easy to work with as the Kat Von D, but I don't love the Kat Von D for the rest of the eyeliner. I don't find that it's as black or as waterproof, so I like to use basically two eyeliners when I do my eyeliner, and the Stila is one of my favorites. I am exploring alternative versions to this that are cheaper, obviously, so some drugstore ones, and so I've got a collection built up to try. So I used one of these up. And last is a deluxe size sample, I guess, of the Marc Jacobs Velvet Noir Mascara. This is one of my favorite mascaras. I think this was actually the first version of it that I'd ever picked up, and I picked it up in Anaheim Disneyland because I'd forgotten a mascara for some reason when I went traveling, and I love this. This is a really great mascara. It is a little bit pricey. I am gonna start exploring some drugstore alternatives, but I really do like this mascara and have repurchased already. All right, so let's move into some hair care. I don't have too many hair care products. The first two are the exact same, and they are the Living Proof Dry Shampoo. I have used two bottles of this. I did recently purchase the Empties dry shampoo to replace this because Sephora was doing their 21 days of hair care event and the Batiste original dry shampoo was a part of that sale. So I picked one of those up for like $4 and this is like 16, 18, 20, something like that. And it can get really expensive and I've already used up two of these. So I'm hoping the Batiste works really well. I've only used it, I think, once so far and it worked okay. If you have recommendations for dry shampoos that you really like that are not as expensive, let me know. Cause I think I've used the Batiste before and I didn't love it. So I don't know. I want something that makes my hair smell good and look good. So if you got any suggestions, leave them down in the comments below. Next, I used up this product by John Frieda. It's the Frizz Ease Daily Nourishment. It's just a leave-in conditioner for your hair. Whenever I get out of the shower and straighten or blow dry and straighten my hair, I always use some kind of protectant. I don't feel like this did much for my hair. And I also don't think John Frieda is a cruelty-free brand. I don't think this was anything to write home about. I did recently purchase something, I don't remember what it was, by a cruelty-free brand in Ulta's 21 Days of Hair Beauty, whatever it's called. So this was meh, I wouldn't repurchase. I did use up 4 little mini perfume samples. The first one I used up was a sample of the Black Opium perfume. This is one of my favorite perfumes, so it's very disappointing that YSL is not cruelty-free. I also used up this little version of Gucci Bamboo, again, not cruelty-free. And also, this Candy Prada perfume. It was very, very sweet, but you know, this is again by a brand, not cruelty free. However, this one, this is Nest's. Okay, this is the perfume Indigo by the brand Nest. Nest is cruelty free. This was okay. Yeah, it smelled okay. It's very floral. I don't know that I would repurchase it. I know that this particular scent is one of their most popular ones, but there's a different one they have. I can't think of what it is. Midnight Floor, maybe, that I really, really like, and I might pick that up eventually, but they're very expensive, so maybe. But I finished this one up, so that's 4 perfumes. Mini versions, but perfumes nonetheless. This is kind of a weird one, but I used it up, so I'm going to include it, and this is a nail polish remover by the brand Cutex Strength Shield. I don't think this is cruelty-free. I don't know for sure, but it worked okay. Not the best in the world, not the worst, but I am planning on picking up the next time I place a nail polish order with one of the cruelty-free brands. I plan on picking up a nail polish remover from one of them, but I haven't yet. We're kind of moving into body care now. The first product I have here is one of the Bite Agave lip masks. This is just the original one. I love these. I've already repurchased one of these and have been using it. I use it every single night when I go to bed and just slather it on my lips. It really just helps protect them and keep them plump and hydrated, so I would highly recommend this. Next, I have this body scrub. This is just like from Amazon. I definitely didn't love it. It was kind of a mess. It's the Arabica coffee scrub by First Botany. I bet that's botany. It says 100% natural. It was basically just like a coffee ground scrub with coconut in it. It worked okay. It wasn't anything to write home about. I wouldn't. Oh, it says it's for cellulite, stretch marks, spider veins, wrinkles, and detoxing. So again, it worked okay. I used it up. Oh gosh, it just spilled on me. There was still water inside. Great. I do like body scrubs. I use them pretty frequently when I shower, but I don't think I'd repurchase this one when there are so many different ones out there that I could try that are maybe better. Next, I used up 2 shower gels by the brand Lush. I love Lush. I wish that we had one closer, but I think the closest one's like 5 hours away. The first one I used up was in the smell bubbly. Oh, it smells so sweet. Oh my God. For some reason, oh my God. You know how a smell can just like trigger a memory or a sensation? This smell reminds me of my honeymoon because I picked it up when Alex and I went to Disneyland for our honeymoon. I don't even know if this is a permanent shower gel. Oh, it smells so good. I want to go back. I am going back, actually. I'm going back to Disneyland this December and I am so excited. I used this up. I loved it. I would absolutely repurchase it. The other shower gel that I also actually picked up on my honeymoon, because there's a Lush right next to Disneyland that we always visit when we go, and that is the shower gel in the scent Happy Hippie. This is also one of my favorites. It's so citrusy and just like zesty. I love it. Listen to the description. Get zest for success with this groovy triple grapefruit gel. So cute. I used up this one too, and I would highly recommend any and all of the Lush shower gels. They just smell so good and they're great. And Lush is cruelty free. Sticking with Lush, I used up a body lotion. This is the body lotion in the shade, in the scent Sleepy. It is a lavender, so let's actually read it. A luxurious rich lavender with tonka lotion to soothe your skin and mind. I really, really liked the smell of this. The only thing was that it didn't fully sink into the skin, which I have a problem with when I put clothes on. If my skin just kind of has that almost oily texture to it, I don't like that. I like my skin to feel moisturized and plumped, but not oily or greasy or any kind of residue left over from a lotion. So that was a little bit disappointing, but I did use this up. I did like it. I tended to use it on my arms a lot before bed because they don't like rub together when I sleep really, so it didn't bother me too much, but it was a little hard to use it on my legs. I do have two more products from Lush, so let's go ahead and just talk about them while I'm on a Lush roll. The first is a face mask, the Rosy Cheeks face mask. This is my favorite face mask, I think, from Lush. The description on it is it soothes and softens cheeks with calming calamine and rose clay. It's a rosy toned looking mask that's very clay-esque, and you rub it all over your skin, wash it off, and it really soothes everything down. It makes my redness go down. It's just so calming. It's hard to explain. I will repurchase this because it works really, really well. And my last Lush product is a cleansing lotion. This is the 9 to 5 cleansing lotion. Here's the description on it. Beautifully light, this orchid and almond oil blend will cleanse skin, leaving it feeling refreshed. I did really like this. I used this for a while in place of a cleansing balm. When I take my makeup off in the evening, I normally take my eye makeup off first and then would use this to take the first layer of makeup off and then use my cleanser brush with a deeper cleanser to scrub deep into my pores. So I did really like that. I would consider repurchasing the bigger size. Okay, I think I have only two more body-ish care products before we get into face care. Actually, I guess one of these is considered face care, but whatever. The first is the Sol de Janeiro Brazilian Bum Bum Cream. This is the original one, and I really, really, really like this. It smells good. Okay, the first time I smelled it, I was definitely expecting a much better smell just because it seemed like everybody hyped it up so much and was mildly disappointed. But the more I used it, the more I liked it. It does have a more vanilla tropical scent, so if you don't like vanilla, you might not like this. The first time Alex smelled it, he didn't like it. The first time he smelled it on me, he really liked it. So I don't know, it's kind of weird. I really, really like this. I will repurchase this eventually, but it's so expensive and I do have a lot of lotions. So I'm working to use those up before I repurchase the full size, because I think the full size is like $45. Eventually, the full size will be mine. I love the way it sinks into the skin. Unlike the Sleepy Lotion from Lush, which kind of leaves a residue on the skin, this doesn't. It just moisturizes so well and is really pleasant to put on because of the smell. So I would highly recommend this. I really, really do like it. I think it works really well and just makes my skin look healthy and smooth. So, which is what you're looking for in a moisturizer, right? So I do have a lip product. This is the Sugar Plum Fairy Lip Scrub. Oh, this is another product by Lush. Oh my gosh, totally missed it. Okay, well, whatever. So this is a lip scrub again by Lush. This took me like 4 or 5 years to use up. Oh my goodness. I did recently buy a replacement, not this lip scrub in particular. I ended up picking one up from Ulta. I don't remember even the brand of it, but I would repurchase one of these because they last so darn long and just work well and they're pleasant to use. This one was like a blackberry scented. Ooh, it smells so good. Oh, I love it. Like sugared blackberry. So good. But as far as lip scrubs go, I think these work really well. Again, this lasted me years and wasn't very expensive, so I would highly recommend these. I think they work, again, very well. Whew. Okay, so now for all skincare. The first product I have is by Kate Somerville. This is the Eradicate Daily Cleanser for acne treatment. Now, I didn't think that This was amazing. I have better cleansers. I use a cleanser by Dermalogica that I absolutely love and I think works really well on my skin. I didn't really notice too much results from this. What's really bad though is that anytime I would use this and then wash my face off with a towel, the towel would smell. I don't know what it is with the Kate Somerville like clay cleansers and products. Like you can kind of see a little bit of the pink up here. Anything that has that pink residue leaves my towels smelling so bad. And I don't know why, but it's with all of them like that. I have a mask that I actually really like by this brand, and all of them leave my towels smelling so bad. So what I elected to do, and what I've elected to do with any cleansers that I either am sent or buy that I don't absolutely love for my face, I use them in the shower on my chest, shoulders, and back because I do sometimes get breakouts there. I just thought that was kind of a perfect solution, especially for this product, because then I just wash it off my body. You don't have to use any towels or anything. It just goes from the tube to my skin down the sink. There's no cross-contamination with anything that would cause it to smell. So that's how I used this product. I just used it in the shower on my chest, shoulders, and back, and just, you know, kind of help those areas get cleansed. And I used it up. It worked okay. I wouldn't repurchase just because it didn't work excellent. And Kate Somerville isn't really inexpensive. So there's my thoughts on this one. Speaking of Dermalogica, I used up another one of their clearing skin washes. I had one in my first empties video in the beginning of the year, and I used up another one between then and now. And now I have, I think, a bigger one than this. I think there was the biggest version, which I thought I might as well get because I love it so much and I still continue to love it. But I used up one of these. If you struggle with adult acne, I would highly, highly recommend this brand. This is the Medibac Clearing System by Dermalogica, and I just think it works really, really well. Next, I used up a Green Clean Makeup Melt Away Cleansing Balm by Pharmacy. This is my absolute favorite cleansing balm right now. I know I've talked about this before, so I won't spend too much time on it, but if you like cleansing balms, pick this up. It is so, so good. I've also tried the Pixie one. I think that was in my empties at the beginning of the year, and it wasn't as good. It left a weird residue on my skin. I loved this. I thought it worked really, really well, and already have another one that I'm using, and we'll pick up a new one when that one runs out. It's great. It's a really great cleansing balm, and Pharmacy is a really great brand, so win-win all around. Next, I used up another one of Tarte's friction sticks. I also had one of these in my empties at the beginning of the year, and I have one currently in my shower. I really like this friction stick. It's just like a charcoal scrub that comes in a tube stick form. When I'm in the shower, normally I do a mask before I shower. I'll put a mask on, let it sit, do a couple things around my room, and then shower, wash it off, and then exfoliate right afterwards using this. It's just a scrub stick that I kind of draw around my face, rub it in with my fingers, wash it off. It smells pretty good. It's just a charcoal scrub and it works really well. So I really enjoy this. I think it's like $20, $22 maybe. I always normally pick one up during the Sephora sales just because I think it works well and I love using it. Speaking of masks, I did use up two masks by Peter Thomas Roth in my Project Pan, my 18 and 2018 this year. The first was the Irish Moor Mud Purifying Black Mask. This was a charcoal black mask. I didn't notice that it did immensely good things for my skin. It worked okay. Charcoal masks always work okay for me. So it was good, but Peter Thomas Roth isn't a cruelty-free brand, so I wouldn't consider purchasing the full size anyways. The other one that I used up is the Cucumber Gel Mask. This was a very hydrating mask. I don't think this did anything for my skin. I talked about that in my last update to my Project Pan. It didn't work for my skin at all. I didn't notice anything and would absolutely not repurchase. Almost done, just a few products left. I used up the Ole Henriksen Sheer Transformation Facial Cream. I actually really like this facial cream. I think it works really well. I love the way that it sinks into my skin and just leaves my skin feeling afterwards. Now that I'm thinking about it though, I mean, I don't have anything, I don't think, currently from Ole Henriksen, and I don't know if they're cruelty-free off the top of my head. There's some brands that just I can't remember if they're cruelty-free or not, and this is one of them. I'll have it on the screen one way or another, but I do really like this. If they are cruelty-free, I would consider repurchasing. Two other things that I used up this year are two sample size Drunk Elephant products. The first is the Be Hydra Intensive Hydration Gel. This is basically a moisturizer, a gel moisturizer. it worked okay. I feel like there's other hydrators that I like more than this, and Drunk Elephant's a very expensive brand, so I don't know that I would repurchase it. If it came in a kit, that would be cool. I would definitely use it and happily use it, but I don't know that I would single this full-size product out and use it alone and purchase it alone. The other thing that I used up was the C Firma Day Serum, and I actually have repurchased this. I really like it, and I like using a vitamin C serum. I purchased during the spring VIB sale two kits that came with a total of 1 ounce of this product, which is the equivalent to one full size of this product, and I expect to have both of those used up before the next VIB sale, which I think will be 6 months, and I think the shelf life on this is 6 months, so that's perfect. I don't think I'll have any problem because I use it every single morning, which is the recommended use for it. Only two more products left. All right, we can get through this. So the first of the last two is this acne treatment by Kate Somerville, the Eradicate Acne Treatment. I like this. The Mario Badescu line has an equivalent to this particular product. It's another just acne treatment in very similar packaging. You normally have this kind of clear treatment in the upper portion of the packaging and then a like clay almost product in the base, and you dip a Q-tip in there and then dot the product around your face wherever you have blemishes. I like these kinds of products. I think they work really well and really reduce the life of acne on your skin. I think both of the products work very, very similar. They're both very good, basically equivalent. I do remember that the Kate Somerville sometimes lasts longer than the Mario Badescu version for whatever reason. I just feel like it doesn't, the clear liquid at the top of it doesn't dissolve as fast, which can make it last a little bit longer, but the Mario Badescu is cheaper, so really they're pretty equivalent in all ways, shapes, and forms. So I like these. I would recommend picking one of the two up. And the last product, not for any reason other than it's just the last one I picked up, is a product by Sunday Riley. This is the UFO Ultra Clarifying Face Oil. I got this in a set with toner and a mask. The mask I haven't quite used up all the way, but I do really like, and the toner I have already repurchased and absolutely love. It's one of like my just favorite products in my bathroom right now. This was okay. Would I repurchase? Maybe. I really like the skincare regime that I have going right now, and it doesn't include an oil like this. I have a lot of products from Drunk Elephant right now in my bathroom that I really love, and those are expensive, and this is expensive. I think I would repurchase the Drunk Elephant ones before I would repurchase this, but I do think this worked okay. It was nice to have a clarifying oil. I know that Sunday Riley has a few different versions of facial oils. Some of them are really, really highly raved about, and I might consider picking up one of those as opposed to another one of these just to try it out, because I really like trying out different skincare. But yeah, I did like this. I would consider repurchasing, but it was very expensive, so I don't know, it's hard to say with this one. All right, so that was a lot of products. I'm sure that that was a lot of money's worth of products, maybe 1,000. Some of those skincare items were really expensive. It might have been closer to like 800. I don't even know. It'd be interesting if I could just calculate out how much all of those were. I might try and do that. If I do that, I'll put it on the screen what the total price was for all of these products. I'm sure it was a lot of money, which it makes me feel good to think that I used up a lot of money worth of products. I got my money's worth out of everything that I used up, which feels good because there's so many things that just kind of sit in your collection, especially makeup. You know, I'm not mad about it. I like having a big-ish collection or an average collection. I don't know. It's hard to say. There's some people who have huge collections. There's some people who have very minimalist collections. I feel like I have a pretty average collection. There's some things that I have a lot more of, like palettes and lipsticks, and there's some things that I don't really have that I have a pretty modest collection of, which is like bronzers, blushes, and highlights. But it feels good to get use out of some products and be able to share my thoughts and opinions with you. If you like Empties videos, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. If you like Project Pan videos, if you like palette roulette videos, shop my stash videos, consider checking out the rest of my channel and consider subscribing for more content from me. And I think that's everything I have for you today. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.